Okay, so let's talk about how do we find the union when we're given two sets of inequalities here. All right, so when it comes to these, depending on the book or the example and stuff that you're doing this from, sometimes it will ask you straight out, find the union of the two inequalities, but sometimes, or a lot of times, it's just gonna give you the word or here. Now, or means union. Okay, so if you see the word or, that's asking you to find the union. If you see the word and, that's asking you to find the intersection. Okay, otherwise, or represents union. So what we're gonna do in order to find the union of two inequalities, well, first we need to solve the two inequalities and graph them. That way we can see what we're looking at. Because when we find the union of something, whether it's the union of two inequalities, two equations, sets, or anything like that, the union just represents uniting everything together. So if we're given two different inequalities, we're gonna take the solutions for both of these inequalities, and we're just gonna put them all together into one. So before we get to that part there, let's solve these first. So starting with the equation on the left over here. So if I'm going to solve this for x, so I'm gonna work on getting x on the left-hand side just because I think when it comes to inequalities, it just makes it easier to read the inequality when you already have your variable on the left side. So I'm gonna say minus 2x minus 2x. So that just means on the right-hand side, I'm gonna have a zero for right now. 6x minus 2x is 4x, and we drop down this minus 4. So I'm going to move that 4 to the other side. Negative 4 plus 4 cancels, and 4x is less than 4. Dividing out the coefficient there, I'm left with x is less than a 1. So I'm going to pause for just a moment over here while I solve that inequality. So solving this inequality here, so it's just a one-step inequality that we need to solve. So remember that this is a negative 3x, so the opposite would be to divide both sides by negative 3. Negative 3 divided by negative 3 cancels, leaving us with an x. On the right-hand side, negative 9 divided by negative 3 is a positive 3, so negative over negative is a positive. But we do need to remember one special rule when it comes to solving inequalities, and the only difference in solving inequalities than solving equations is this rule that states that when you divide or when you multiply or divide by a negative number, you have to flip the inequality symbol. So we need to make sure that we get that done. Now, the next thing I'm gonna do here is I'm going to go ahead and graph the solutions for both of them. So I'm gonna use one graph for each. So first off, we have x is less than 1, right? So let's see, so I have a 1 over here, and then we have a 3. All right, so 1, 2, 3. And the only reason I do that is because here I have a 1 for this one, I have a 3 for that, and I want them to line up nice just so when I'm looking at my two graphs, I mean, I'm matching them up perfectly on top of each other so they're not kind of a little skewed. Otherwise, if x is less than 1, so let's see, x is less than 1, so that means I have an open dot at 1, and I'm shading everything to the left. X is greater than or equal to 3, so that means I have a solid dot on 3, and I'm shading everything to the right. So when it comes to finding the union, again, I'm just uniting both of them together. So try and picture if I took these two graphs here and squished them together all into one, what would it look like? And so what would my final product look like here? So if I literally took these and merged them into one graph, just squeezed them together like that, all right, my graph would look like this. So we have an open dot at 1, and we had everything shaded over here. But then we also have a solid dot at 3 and have everything to the right shaded. So this right here is what my solution graph would look like because I'm just putting both of these together. Now, sometimes you could also be asked to find the interval notation of this graph here. So if you are asked for that, so interval notation just represents our answers from left to right. So from the left-hand side, again, this arrow represents it's going all the way to negative infinity. So we would have negative infinity all the way to a 1. Right? Infinities always have parentheses on them. Open dots like this always have parentheses. But then we also have, so we're union, We also have answers starting from 3, and I'm sorry, that's supposed to be a bracket. If you have a solid dot, it's always a bracket. And we have 3 here, and then that's going to go all the way to positive infinity. So this is what our graph would look like along with our interval notation on finding the union given 2 inequalities.